time to put you in the driver's seat. Every day at this time, we turn the controls over to the fans, and you pick the music and talk Bruce. You're the boss on E Street Radio.
Hi, I'm Tracy Vail, born and raised in New York City, and today I'm the boss on E Street Radio. I've been a huge fan of Bruce and his music since Born to Run came out, and it's such a pleasure to be able to share some stories of music with fellow boss fanatics like myself. Today's show is going to feature some Bruce rarities you might not have heard on any other station. Yep, we're talking outtakes, rare live cuts, and for the first time ever, the story behind my long-awaited and only encounter with the man himself. The first song you're going to hear is an outtake from the River album. I first heard it in the early 80s at Bleecker Bob's record store in Greenwich Village. The place was well known for carrying rare records, okay, some might call them bootlegs, and at that time, Bruce was only releasing official stuff every 2 or 3 years, so my friends and I were desperate to hear any new music. I was going through the stacks of 45s and found this Springsteen single I had never seen before. It had amazing artwork. I begged the guy behind the counter to play it, and I was just blown away how good the first song was. I mean, how was it possible this had never been released? He wanted $30 for it, which was a lot of money at the time. I mean, I think Bruce concert tickets were only around $11. Well, I couldn't afford it, and it killed me to leave the store without it. But my patience was finally rewarded 28 years later when the song was finally released on Trax. Here at long last is Take 'Em As They Come.
Oh, Got a favorite song? Great story from a Bruce concert? Share your love of all things Springsteen and be the boss on E Street Radio.
Picked by the fans, for the fans. You're the boss on E Street Radio, the home of Bruce Springsteen.
That was None with the Brave, which is a Born in the USA outtake that was finally released on the Essential Bruce Springsteen Collection and features a killer sax solo from the big man. I never got a chance to meet Clarence, and even though I had seen Bruce so many times in concert, I've never even come close to meeting him. So, it's early 1991, and I was living in Los Angeles, when I got a call from a friend of mine who was installing computers at a dentist's office in Beverly Hills. Apparently, the receptionist had just told him that Bruce Springsteen was coming in for an appointment. My heart starts pounding. It's the call I've been waiting for 16 years. I check my watch. It's 10:30. I have a half hour to get down there. So I grab a bunch of posters, albums, and race out the door into my car, which was an old 73 Corvair, I believe. I'm driving like a maniac, weaving in and out of traffic, and suddenly I hear this sputtering sound, and the car just stops. That annoying Ralph Nader was right. These cars stink. This is before cell phones, of course, but luckily I'm near a hotel. So I just leave the car on the side of the road and call a cab. It comes in about 10 minutes, and I zoom off down to Beverly Hills. I'm really late and thinking I missed my chance, so I take the elevator upstairs, find the dentist's office, and run into the waiting room, looking like a maniac, I'm sure. I don't know what I expected to find, but there he was, sitting right in front of me, Bruce Springsteen. I sit right next to him with a bag full of memorabilia, and I stammer out a, "Hey, Bruce." He looks at me kind of confused and goes, "Hey." Just then, he gets called to go in. A minute later, the receptionist tells me I can't wait here, so I go downstairs to the lobby and wait for him there. Sure enough, about a half hour later, he comes out of the elevator, and I'm really nervous. But I tell him how much his music has meant to me, what a huge fan I am. I mean, I'm just stammering, but I think he understands I'm kind of nervous. He said thank you, and we shook hands. I pulled out a poster from the sign. He says, "One thing, how'd you know I was going to be here?" I confess, I didn't want to get my friend in trouble, so I made something up. But I told him I could have brought all my friends, and it was such a hard secret to keep. I said, "Remember when you climbed the fence at Elvis's house to meet him?" He nodded and said, "Who should I make it out to?" I spelled out my name and thanked him, and then I pulled out my Darkness album, and he said, "Okay, this is the last one. This is a favor now." He signed it and headed for the door, probably relieved the encounter was over. I yelled out, "Oh, by the way, I love that new song you just played at the Shrine, The Real World." "Thanks, man," he said as the door closed behind him. From the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, 1990, here is the first ever performance of The Real World. Oh,
waist deep and sinking into this black river.
Street Radio. We turn the controls over to the fans. You pick the music and talk Bruce. And you can be the boss.
We'll be right back.
You're the boss. Guest DJed by you, the fans, on E Street Radio.
That was 30 Days Out, which is the B-side to the Lucky Town single, which, funny enough, did not make it on the Trax album. Great bass line by Gary Talent, by the way. This is Tracy Vail from New York City, and I've been the boss today. Hey, if you'd like a shot at getting on the air and tell your best boss stories, email betheboss@SiriusXM.com. You know, I've seen Bruce and the E Street Band maybe 40 times in concert, starting with the Darkness Tour. But my favorite show has to be the Nassau Coliseum show, Long Island, New York, December 31st, 1980. Bruce and the E Street Band have only played three times on New Year's Eve. It was the 75 Philly, 78 in Cleveland, and this show. We had seats just to the side of the stage, so it almost felt like you were in the band, and the energy from the crowd was amazing. It was like I had picked the set list. He was playing all my favorites, and rare ones, too. I remember there was A Night, Who'll Stop the Rain, Rendezvous, even A Merry Christmas Baby. It was a few minutes before midnight, and Bruce called an audible, playing Held Up Without a Gun, a B-side from the river he had never played before. The band then broke into Midnight Hour right before the clock struck 12, and then continued playing for another hour until both the band and audience were truly exhausted, and a little drunk, I might add. 38 songs and almost 4 hours long, it was a night to remember. I'm going to end the show with a song from that night that still holds up 32 years later, The Price You Pay. Thanks for listening.
Will you make up your mind? You choose the chance you take. You ride to where the highway ends and the desert breaks out onto an open road. You ride until their hands held high, they reached out for the open skies. And in one last breath, they built the roads they drive to their dead. Driving on through the night, unable to break away from the rest. Some they say don't look back, but for every breath you take, will you leave a track? And though it don't seem fair, for every smile that plays, the tear must fall somewhere. Where you can walk away.
little girl down on the strand with that pretty little baby in your hands. Do you remember the story of the promised land? How we crossed the desert sands, they could not enter the chosen.
Favorite song? Great story from a Bruce concert? Share your love of all things Springsteen. Email us at bethebossatsiriusxm.com and Be The Boss on E Street Radio.